Welcome, everybody, and today I want to tell you a bit about South African food. Now, I guess the reason why one travels is that you want to discover new things, you want to see new places, and you just want to experience another way of life, and thereby probably find inspiration, I guess, or just to bring your life into perspective. And so travel is a great way to getting to know, I suppose, other people, other parts of the world. And while you are traveling, you also meet new people, you know, on the coach. So those people, you know, of course, as you travel over many, many years, they become friends and they become family. And so it's just great to travel. But today I want to talk about food. Now, when you visit a new country, then the first thing that I suppose you should look at is, what did the original indigenous people of that country eat? Because today when you travel, it's great to go to a restaurant, but most of what you're going to eat there is probably what you can get at home. So you go to a fine dining place, hardly ever do they serve you the indigenous stuff. So what are the indigenous stuff mostly in South Africa? Let's talk about South Africa. Mostly in South Africa, we start with herbs, because in this part of the country where I come from, which is Cape Town, the southern part, the southwestern part of the country, we have the fynbos or fynbos plant kingdom. It's said to be the richest, the smallest, but the richest plant kingdom in the world. And so we have a huge variety of indigenous plants. Mostly today, it's the herbs that is making its way into the kitchens of some hotels, restaurants and guest houses. And very seldom does one actually find spices, indigenous spices that makes its way into our kitchens. Now, of course, you know, herbs are the leafy parts of the plant, and spices are what comes from the roots and what comes from the bark and what comes from the branches and so on. But the herbs are the leafy parts, and it's mostly the herbs that makes its way into the kitchens. Not in any big way, because the indigenous plants are very difficult to cultivate. They're very difficult, first of all, to propagate and then to cultivate and then, you know, to use or exploit commercially, because they grow, most of them grow in such difficult and very specific environments. Now, if you know something about the South African climate, you know something about the terroir in this part of the world, then you know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm not going to divulge too much, but I'm going to put up a list of what it is that you can try and what it is you can look for when you come to visit South Africa, because this is what this is all about. This talk is all about. I'd like you to explore for yourself. And so all I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a list of things that you can try when you're here. I would love you to come and explore for yourself. It's no good me putting up a whole explanation of what I think it tastes like and what it is. Come and explore it, and then you can tell us, or you can tell your friends, what it is to you. That's what discovery is all about. You don't want to be going on somebody else's holiday. You want to go on to your own adventure, on your own route of discovery. Because when you come on a you come on a tour, but what you've actually been sold is an experience. That's what it is. And so there it is. I'm putting up the list, and then I'm also going to put up a link where you can go onto my website, which will have a copy of a list of the goods that you can try, but it's a printable copy, and have fun. Now, when you get to a restaurant, for example, or an area where there are many restaurants in South Africa, here's another tip for you. Don't just eat what they have on the menu. Ask them what on the menu is South African, or what is it that they can make up for you from the menu that is South African. And don't always just eat at one restaurant, you know, if you have the time. You can have starters at one, and you can have some more starters somewhere else, entrees somewhere else, and then you can have a main course or two somewhere else if you're taking small portions. But keep moving around and find those restaurants that make South African food. And then you can also ask the waiter, what is it that you eat at home? Or the waitress, ask them, what do you eat at home? Ask the chef or ask the restaurant manager, what do you make for your staff? Because sometimes it's not going to be, or most times it's not going to be what is served as fine dining. It's going to be closer to home food. So do that. It's very exciting. And when you come here, I know you're going to have a great time. We can't wait to host you. And come on, join us. I'd love to share my passion with you.